Obviously, it's a very sensitive and disappointing for the players, both current and past.
It's a different world these days.
Right now, we're trying to limit the damage.
It's being described as a disgusting, appalling, gross breach of privacy.
Understanding that the majority of the images are fake, made up, staged, all sorts of stuff. It's someone grubby who hopefully will very quickly get caught.
45 files of nude and graphic images leaked online, titled with the names of AFL players. The link spread like wildfire across social media. The AFL says it appears significant work was involved in gathering the images, and at this stage, it has no idea why someone would have done this.
Some of the feedback already is it's not me, and having seen some of the images, like there's a lot that have got no faces attached to them, so there's probably some grey around, you know, whether a lot of the players are actually, it's images of them.
It's nasty, isn't it? It's nasty.
Premiership players and Brownlow medalists are among those named in the unverified images. The AFL Integrity Unit, Victoria Police and the eSafety Commission launching a joint investigation.
Material that is shared in this kind of way can attract a prison penalty. So the criminal offence can be punished by time in jail. We can seek a court order penalising them up to more than $100,000 per offence.
The Google Drive has been removed, but there's concern the photos have been downloaded and shared elsewhere.
We do very much urge people not to share those. They could expose themselves to serious criminal and or civil penalties.
It's more about just throwing things out there and then leaving everyone else to clean up with it and the effect that it has on people's lives. And families.
The sleazy move sparking yet another warning for young players. Think twice before you hit send.
People make mistakes and we often forget that our players are coming into our system as young adults and they'll make mistakes. So our view is that we'll always support our players and acknowledge they make mistakes and work through that with them.
I hope this is the last we hear of it until someone is charged and dealt with and it doesn't get the oxygen that they're seeking.